Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the class. We are continuing classical genetics in this chapter. Today, terminology related to the Mendelism. Under this title, we are going to discuss various aspects. Let us start. Mendel noticed two different expressions of a trait. Here, keep remember, trait means character. Example, tall and dwarf. Tall and dwarf are the two alternative form of plant height or stem height. Traits are expressed in different ways due to the fact that a gene can exist in two alternative forms, such as versions, for the same trait. Hence, it is called alleles. So, traits are expressed in different ways due to the fact that the gene can exist in alternate forms or versions of the same trait called alleles. If an individual has two identical alleles of a gene, hence it is called homozygous. Homo, similar, zygous, zygote. A zygote which carrying two alleles which are identical. Example, capital T, capital T. This capital T, which denotes tall as a trait in Pisum sativum. An individual with different alleles. Is called heterozygous. Hetero, different, zygote. So, zygote which contains two different alleles, namely capital T and small t. Capital T and small t, which is called a heterozygous condition of alleles. Mendel's non-true breeding parents are called or Mendel's non-true breeding plants are called as heterozygous. Heterozygous are often called hybrids because they carry two different alleles from different parents. Let us discuss the term homozygous and heterozygous, recessive as well as dominant. Recessive as well as dominant. Homozygous and heterozygous. These two terms which made difference in meaning. When the gene has two alleles, the dominant allele is symbolized with a capital letter. Example, capital T, which you can see. So the capital T, for example, it denotes or symbolizes the dominant character, whereas the small t, which represents as recessive character. I'm repeating. When the gene has two alleles, the dominant allele is symbolized with the capital letter, whereas the recessive allele is in small letter. When both alleles are recessive, the individual is called as homozygous recessive. Example, small t, which you can observe. Small t, which collectively called as homozygous recessive dwarf plants, that means dwarf pea plants, in which the both alleles are recessive. In which both alleles are shows recessive state. But another form, an individual with two dominant alleles, is called as homozygous dominant. The homozygous dominant will be represented by or symbolized by capital T, which called tall pea plants. The homozygous means, already we knew that, the individual which has two identical alleles or genes. So individual has two identical alleles or gene which is in recessive state called as small t, whereas in the dominant state it is called as capital T. Sometimes an individual which possesses two different alleles, one represents the dominant allele called a capital T with another one as recessive allele called small t together, which is called as capital T small t, denotes non-true breeding tall pea plants, which denotes non-true breeding tall pea plants called heterozygous tall. This heterozygous tall carries two different alleles from the parents, also known as hybrids. Let us continue. Mendelian inheritance and Mendel's law of heredity. Mendel proposed two rules based on the observations on monohybrid cross. Dear students, you know that monohybrid cross in which only one pair of contrasting character alone is used for a cross is called monohybrid cross. We already discussed in 10th standard itself. Today, the rules of the Mendel called laws of inheritance. Mendel proposed three laws based on the observations of monohybrid as well as the dihybrid cross. The first law of the inheritance is the law of dominance. The second law is law of segregation. These scientific laws which play important role in the history of evolution. Dear student, now you are observing law of dominance. Let us start the law of dominance. The characters are controlled by discrete units called factors. During the Mendelian period, there is no term genes. Mendel did not use the term genes. He called the discrete units as factors or alleles. These discrete units which control the characters are always occurs in pairs. In a dissimilar pair of factors, one member of the pair is dominant and another member of the parent is recessive. The law of dominance, which gives an explanation to the Mendel monohybrid cross, you can observe. First, the expression of only one parental character alone is seen in the F1 generation. You know that Mendel monohybrid cross, in which tall parent of the Pisum sativum is crossed with the dwarf parent, both were pure breedings having homozygous condition of alleles. Gametes of the parents fused zygote form, the first generation in which all of them were tall. But keep remember, they have alleles of two different parents, one from the male parent, another from the female parent. So out of the two characters of the parent generation, such as tall and dwarf, in which only one of the parental character alone appears in the F1 generation. This is point one. Point number two, when the F1 generation plants are, or F1 generation hybrids, when they are crossed, the expression of both the parents appear in the F2 generation. It is explained in the name of proportion, that is 3:1. We call it is phenotypic ratio. So the phenotypic ratio of the F2 generation of Mendel monoamic cross is 3:1. So in F1 generation, one point is very clear. Out of the two parent in which only one parent character alone is appeared, which is called a dominant. The character which is not appear on the F1 generation is recessive character. The plant is recessive plant. But when the F1 generations are self-pollinated, in F2 generation, both tall as well as the dwarf character of the parents. That means both the parental characters appeared in F2 generation in the ratio of 3:1. Let us come to the next one. The law of segregation is also known as law of purity of gametes. We knew that alleles do not show any blending where both the characters are seen as such in F2 generation, although one of the character is not seen in the F1 generation. In Mendel's monohybrid cross, tall and dwarf parents, when they cross, only one character alone is appeared in the F1 generation. During the formation of gametes, the factors are alleles of a pair and segregate. I'm repeating, during the formation of gametes, the factors are alleles of a pair separate and segregate from each other such that each gamete which receives only one of the two factors. For example, F1 generation in monohybrid cross, the alleles are capital T and small t. During the gamete formation in F1 generation, capital T is the allele goes to one gamete and small t goes to another gamete. So a homozygous parent produce always similar gametes. In a heterozygous parent which produces two kinds or two different gametes, each having one allele with equal proportion, this we called as law of segregation. Dear children, please remember, gametes never hybrid. In this case, alleles do not blend. That we can understand. Dear students, in the continuous session, we are also going to look after how the color of the flower is changed. Let us see. There was a question arise. Can you identify Mendel gene for regulating white color in the flower in peas? There was an answer found through by the study of molecular genetics. Let us find the molecular answer to understand the gene's function. A long, mysterious question having answer now. How it is? It is quite fascinating to trace the Mendel's genes. In 2010, the gene responsible for regulating the flower color in the peas was identified by an international team of researchers. It was named by them as P gene A. This gene, which encodes a protein that function as transcription factor which is responsible for the production of anthocyanin pigment. Anthocyanin pigment which gives purple color. So the flowers are purple in color. In pea plants, white flowers do not have anthocyanin, even though they have the gene that codes the enzyme involved in anthocyanin pigment synthesis. Researchers delivered a normal copies of gene A, into the cells of petals of white flowers by a gene gun method. When a gene enters into a small percentage of cells of white flowers, it exposes in those particular cells accumulated anthocyanin pigments and became purple. In white flowers, the gene A sequence showed a single nucleotide change that makes the transcription factor active. Inactive. In white flowers, the gene A sequence showed a single nucleotide change that makes the transcription factor inactive. So, a mutant form of gene A do not accumulate anthocyanin, hence the flowers are white. Dear children, many mysterious questions are resolved. We found the answer through by molecular genetics. In the next class, we will continue monobit cross in the chapter classical genetics. Thank you, children. Thank you once again.